So Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu used to give in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the most he gave, he spent to free the Muslims who are weak, who cannot help themselves, and he freed them like Bilal radiallahu anhu and other Muslims and other Sahabiyat. Mistah, another name that we should remember. Mistah is a name of a poor man in the time of the Prophet. If you remember the Hadith al-Ifk, the story that happened with Aisha radiallahu anha, when she was behind the army and the people with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and she lost her bracelet or necklace in the desert. And she started looking for it. She didn't find it. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sahaba, they started moving. Back in this time, there was no communication system. It was a tribal place, and they go with each other to a place. They put the tents and they stay for some time, and then somebody will call, "We are leaving after like 10 minutes, 15 minutes, or we're leaving now." And then everybody will back up and then they will leave. Aisha, when they called to leave, Aisha was outside and she lost her necklace. She started looking for it, she didn't find it. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and the Sahaba, they thought that Aisha is here. She used to ride the camel with some kind of arrangements above the camel that is covering the women. So women used to ride camels, but they used to cover them, some kind of covering, so they are away from the sun and from also the wind, and also they are away from the eyes of the people. So they thought that Aisha is in. Nobody checked on her. And then when they started going into Medina, they figured out that Aisha is not there. And also they had a technique at that time. If we are leaving, someone should stay behind the group. When they leave, he looks for something, if they miss something or they forgot something. So one of the Sahaba, Ridwanullahi alayhim, he was behind. And he found Sayyida Aisha radiallahu anha by herself. And he found the group is gone and she is by herself in the middle of the desert. And he radiallahu anhu, he got his camel and he let her mount the camel, and he took the camel until they arrived Medina. When they arrived Medina, one of the munafiqs, one of the hypocrites, Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul, started like spreading rumors about the Sayyida Aisha radiallahu anha, saying, "Aisha, the Prophet of Muhammad coming with this man, I think there is something has been going on with both two of these, Aisha and that man." So he started spreading the rumors about Aisha that she has done fahisha radiallahu anha. And then people started talking about this. "Aisha, did you see what Aisha did? This. And these rumors, they reach it everywhere. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam has become aware of these things. And he sallallahu alayhi wasallam, as we know, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not send in him anything to him, any revelation, any wahi to clear this. So he sallallahu alayhi wasallam did not know what happened. And then he talked to Aisha radiallahu anha. "Aisha, if what the people say, it was going on, it happened, just ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness and tell me, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you." And Aisha radiallahu anha was feeling very bad and sad. And she moved from her, from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam house to her father's house. And she said, "Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I will ask forgiveness from Allah, and I will ask help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I will not talk until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed a Quran clearing the issue and explaining that Aisha radiallahu anhu is a very clear and pure, and she is the mother of the believer, and she didn't do anything." One of the people who talked about this was a weak Sahabi that Sayyidina Abu Bakr used to give him money and spend on him. His name is Mistah. So Abu Bakr, this is his daughter, Aisha. And this rumors going on. So when he knew that Mistah is involved in this, and he is talking and carrying tales in this story, he said, "I will never give him anything. I will stop my giving to him." So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Quran in this, in this story of Misbah, and what Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu intended to do, to stop the expenses that he is given to Misbah because of Misbah talking about Aisha radiallahu anha. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا يَأْتَلِ أُولُو الْفَضْلِ مِنْكُمْ وَالسَّعَةِ أَيْ وَلَا يَأْتَلِ أُولُو الْفَضْلِ مِنْكُمْ وَالسَّعَةِ أَيُّوتُ أُولُو الْقُرْبَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling Sayyidina Abu Bakr, those who have been given from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they should not stop giving. Those who are relatives and poor, they used to give and spend on. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَن يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Don't you like, don't you love that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives you, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiving? When this ayah was revealed, Sayyidina Abu Bakr said, yes, I love that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives me. And he started giving Misbah again and spending on Misbah again. So this tells us that Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu was very generous radiallahu anhu, and he was always supporting the Sahaba, the weak ones, giving them, helping them from his own money radiallahu anhu. Another ayah, as most of the scholars, they say, whenever we see ayah in the Quran that praises the munfiqeen, the ones who give, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu is included in this ayah. Any ayah that praises those who give, Abu Bakr will be included in this ayah. One of the ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لا يستوي منكم من أنفق من قبل الفتح وقاتل أولئك أعظم درجة من الذين أنفقوا من بعد وقاتلوا. Allah is saying, those who spend on Islam and Muslims before the Fath Mecca, they will not be as the ones who spend after the Fath. Because the ones who spend before, it was difficult time. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward them more and give them more. فالذين سبقوا إلى الإنفاق والقتال قبل الحديبية أفضل ممن بعدهم وأبو بكر الصديق رضي الله عنه أفضل من هؤلاء كلهم فرضي الله عنه. Abu Bakr and Umar, as we know from the beginning of time when they started being Muslims, they used to compete in goodness. And this is the example of all the Muslims. We should all compete when there is something going on, a charity project or something going on that we can help. We should compete. We should tell each other, there is a project over there, feeding the poor, helping the orphans, this. Then we should be all involved in this. So Sayyidina Abu Bakr and Umar, they always compete in giving for the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu, he narrates this hadith. He said, أَمَرَنَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أَنَّ تَصَدَّقَ فَوَافَقَ ذَلِكَ مِنِّي مَالًا. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم called all of us as Sahaba to give charity. And when he صلى الله عليه وسلم announced it, I had some money. فَقَالَ النَّبِيُّ مَا أَبْقَيْتَ لِأَهْلِكَ فَقُلْتُ مِثْلَهُ. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم questioned Umar, Umar, what did you leave for your family? Umar gave some money to the Prophet. The Prophet is asking, what did you leave to your family? He said, I left to my family the same. So I got the two halves of my money. I gave one half to the Prophet and one half to my family. وَأَتَى أَبُو بَكْرٍ بِكُلِّ مَا عِنْدَهُ فَقَالَ يَا أَبَا بَكْرٍ مَا أَبْقَيْتَ لِأَهْلِكَ قَالَ أَبْقَيْتُ لَهُمُ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ قُلْتُ لَا أُسَابِقَهُ إِلَى شَيْءٍ أَبَدًا. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, he got all what he had. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asking him, as he asked Umar, said, Abu Bakr, what did you leave to your family? Abu Bakr as-Siddiq said, I left for them Allah and His Messenger. So Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu said, I never compete and go in competition with Abu Bakr after this. Because I realized that whatever I can do, Abu Bakr is ahead of me all the time. So I try to go ahead of him, but he radiallahu anhu always is ahead of me. As we know, Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, some of his characteristics we talk about this before, to be the companion of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to be a sahib, the companion of Sayyidina Muhammad. And as we know, a sahib or suhba means companionship, and he radiallahu anhu was the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وثبت في الصحيح عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال يأتي زمان يغزو فئام من الناس فيقال لهم هل فيكم من صحب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وفي لفظ هل فيكم من رأى رسول الله فيقولون نعم فيفتح لهم ثم يغزو فئام من الناس فيقال لهم هل فيكم من صحب من صحب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فيقولون نعم فيفتح لهم ثم تغزو فئام من الناس فيقال لهم هل فيكم من رأى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وفي لفظ من صحب رسول الله فيقولون نعم فيفتح لهم وفي لفظ فيذكر الطبقة الرابعة كذلك. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is saying in a hadith, a time will come for my ummah that they will go for ghazw, for battles, and people will ask them, do you have among you companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? They will say yes. And then the time will pass, and then the Muslims will also go into battles, and they will open some countries, and they will be asking, do you have anyone who has seen the ones who have seen Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? And they will say yes, and then they will open for them until they will mention four generations from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, meaning the companionship of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is something very unique and very distinct or distinguished. It is not something that we just come by and talk about short and just leave. No, it is something very valuable. فَقَدْ عَلَّقَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ الْحُكْمَ بِصُحْبَتِهِ وَعَلَّقَ بِرُؤْيَتِهِ وجعل فتح الله على المسلمين بسبب من رآه مؤمنا به وهذه الخاصية لا تثبت لأحد غير الصحابة ولو كانت أعمالهم أكثر من أعمال الواحد من الصحابة. So the companionship is something that has been given to the صحابة رضوان الله عليهم, and nobody else can take the merits of the صحابة who have seen the Prophet, lived with him and stay with him for some time. Then Abu Bakr is one of these, and he is on the top, because as we know, the first mu'min is Abu Bakr after Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The first man in Islam is Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. Sayyidina Khadija, when Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came from the mountain, when Jibreel alayhi salam came to him and commanded him to read, Khadija was the first one to know, and then Waraqa knew this, and then Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu was the first one to say La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah from the men. And as we know, from the young generation was Zayd ibn Haritha and Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu. Zayd ibn Haritha was a servant to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the house of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at that time. And also Ali radiallahu anhu was his cousin. So these two, they are the first young men who accepted Islam. So Abu Bakr was the first companion of the Prophet. He was his companion before Islam, but when Islam and Risala came, he was the first man to say La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah after Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why he was given this unique stamp of being the companion of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we know the story of Hijra, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the ayat in Surah At-Tawbah, إِلَّا تَنْصُرُوهُ فَقَدْ نَصَرَهُ اللَّهُ إِذْ أَخْرَجَهُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا ثَانِيَ اثْنَيْنِ إِذْ هُمَا فِي الْغَارِ إِذْ يَقُولُ لِصَاحِبِهِ لَا تَحْزَنْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَنَا فَأَنزَلَ اللَّهُ سَكِينَتَهُ عَلَيْهِ وَأَيَّدَهُ بِجُنُودٍ لَّمْ تَرَوْهَا وَجَعَلَ كَلِمَةَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا السُّفْلَى وَكَلِمَةُ اللَّهِ هِيَ الْعُلْيَا وَاللَّهُ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ. In this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, if you don't make Muhammad victorious, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for sure will make him victorious. When the people drove him out of Mecca, the second of two means there were two, Sayyidina Muhammad and Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. So Abu Bakr al-Siddiq is mentioned here, and there is no one else can be understood from the ayah except Abu Bakr, the second of two. إِذْ هُمَا فِي الْغَارِ, they were both in the ghar, in the cave. Also Abu Bakr and Sayyidina Muhammad. إذ يقول لصاحبه. Then Sayyidina Muhammad is saying to his companion. Who is the companion? Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. لا تحزن إن الله معنا. Do not be sad. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with us. Mean Sayyidina Muhammad and Abu Bakr. فأنزل الله سكينته عليه على سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وأبو بكر وأيده بجنود لم تروها. الله سبحانه وتعالى has sent his سكينة tranquility, and Allah سبحانه وتعالى has sent soldiers that you cannot see, angels protecting them. وجعل كلمة الذين كفروا السفلى, the word of those who do not believe will be the lowest one, and the word of Allah سبحانه وتعالى is the highest one, and Allah سبحانه وتعالى the mighty and all wise subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, as the ulama explain this ayah, dalala ala afdaliyat Siddiq min sab'ati awjuh. ففي الآية الكريمة من فضل أبي بكر الصديق لا ريب أن الفضيلة التي حصلت لأبي بكر في الهجرة لم تحصل لغيره من الصحابة بالكتاب والسنة والإجماع, فتكون هذه الأفضلية ثابتة له دون عمر وعثمان وعلي وغيرهم من الصحابة. The preference of Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu on the day of Hijrah, that he was chosen to be the companion of Sayyidina Muhammad, this was a preference given to him by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he is superior to Umar and Uthman and Ali radiallahu anhum jami'a. And the ayah has many things. So brothers and sisters, if we just focus in this, we will end inshallah with this. This ayah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, if you do not make Muhammad victorious, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make him victorious. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left Mecca because the disbelievers drove him out, and he was the second of two. Second of two means Muhammad and Abu Bakr. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. And then there is a reference to Abu Bakr in the ayah in many times. Second of two. And then إِذْ هُمَا فِي الْغَارِ, both of them are in the cave. So Sayyidina Muhammad and Abu Bakr again. إِذْ هُمَا فِي الْغَارِ, both of them. إِذْ يَقُولُ لِصَاحِبِهِ, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is talking to his companion. Who is the companion? Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. لَا تَحْزَنْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَنَا. Do not be sad, Allah is with us. Us means Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. فأنزل الله سكينته عليه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent the sakina, the tranquility, the peace upon Sayyidina Muhammad and Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. وأيده بجنود لم تروها. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala supported them with soldiers that you cannot see, angels. First, so the Shaykh here is getting the ayah in details, and he's trying to explain first. And al-kuffar akhrajuh, the disbeliever, they drove Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam out. ثاني اثنين فلازم أن يكونوا أخرجوهما وهذا هو الواقع فإن الكفار أخرجوا المهاجرين كلهم. So ثاني اثنين means that it wasn't just Muhammad, it was Abu Bakr also, who was pushed out, driven out from Mecca. للفقراء المهاجرين الذين أخرجوا من ديارهم وأموالهم يبتغون فضلا من الله ورضوانه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains about the poor sahaba who have been driven out from Mecca because of their Islam. And also, أنه صاحبه الوحيد. The only companion to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. أنه صاحبه في الغار. He radiallahu anhu is the companion of the Prophet in the cave. As we can see, when they left Mecca going to Ghar Thawr, stayed 3 days there, the only companion of Sayyidina Muhammad is Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. And if you listen to the story, when Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, he is explaining himself in the hadith, and he's saying, نَظَرْتُ إِلَىٰ أَقْدَامِ الْمُشْرِكِينَ عَلَىٰ رُؤُوسِنَا وَنَحْنُ فِي الْغَارِ. I was looking at the feet of the disbelievers, they are outside of the cave. Abu Bakr, he was seeing them from inside. فقلت يا رسول الله لو أن أحدهم نظر إلى قدميه لا بصرنا. Oh messenger of Allah, if one of them just looks under his feet, he can see us. If you go inshallah to Mecca and Medina, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the chance to go there inshallah and to see the places that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has been there and going. The Ghar and the Jabal itself, Jabal Thawr, it is very high mountain, very high. And it was very steep to go there. Nowadays, they did put some stairs, kind of stairs, to go. And many of us couldn't go out because it was very super hot. So imagine, 1400 years ago, the situation was totally different. And the mountain was totally different. And Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam takes the pain. And Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu takes the pain. And they mount this huge mountain. And you go to the cave is very small and narrow. And they both go in. And they hide.